stuff up top. Fuck. That's what we were going to open with. Are you guys excited to be at Jay's album recording? Yeah. That makes one of us.
Round of applause if you've been to the Magic Time Machine before.
3, 2, 1, go. Oh, thank
Welcome, guys and gals. Ecomody.
Appreciate y'all tuning in to this very weird and different version of our show, but we're really excited.
Are so glad to be here. I can't even tell you.
Don't choke on your. Yeah. We've got some awesome
videos.
Instead of doing a normal live stand-up show, we actually have asked a lot of a couple comics to send us. Videos.
If you've never seen an Ecomody before, it's a monthly show that me and Bryan do every first Friday. We host it together, and then we have a bunch of cool comics on, and they do their sets. Obviously, we can't do stand-up right now in front of a live audience. These live videos are getting a bit brutal, so we kind of switched up the format, and we got some comics to send us in some clips about what they're doing during quarantine. So we got Tori Poole, Amador Salazar.
Is it quarantine?
Gabby Tinarina.
Is it quarantine, or is it...
San Giuliano.
Or is it lockdown?
Me and Bryan still interrupt each other, even when we're on camera. I think the correct term is social isolation. I feel like quarantine is more related to if you have or think you have the virus. Bryan obviously has it, and that's why he is quarantining, and I am social isolating. Because I am healthy as a slightly unhealthy horse.
All right.
How's this time going for you, Bryan?
To be honest, I'm pretty miserable right now. I've been drinking a lot. I haven't seen or talked to my parents in forever. My relationship is kind of in shambles right now. I'm super depressed. I've been jerking off a lot. It's just
I guess I'm sorry to hear that. You know, quarantine's a hard time.
Oh, quarantine. No. Quarantine's great. I've just been doing a lot of puzzles and shit.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, those things did kind of just seem like your normal
cats,
life.
Dogs.
I didn't want to say anything, but...
landscapes.
Yeah. I think if I come to the point where I start doing puzzles, I've definitely hit my rock bottom. There's no coming back after you start doing puzzles.
I mean, there's pictures of rocks, too. I mean, whatever kind of puzzle you want to do, you know, they have it.
Okay. You're right. Maybe it's not puzzles in general, but just the kind of puzzle that you're doing. It's a good metaphor for life. I'm not exactly sure how it connects, but...
Well, what about you? What have you been up to during this time?
Me? You know what? I've just been taking a little me time. I've been really trying to focus in on my day-to-day, and I've really been thinking about my mental health and trying to track it.
Okay. How are you doing that?
Actually, I've created some, I've been keeping hard notes and data, field notes, if you will, and I've created some what I call isolation graphs to kind of show what I'm going through.
Cool. Let's see what you got.
My first one, it's a fun one, you can take this home to the family, it's my caffeine versus my activity. So for all these graphs, the x-axis is going to be time. And about halfway through is when the isolation starts. So you can see here, my caffeine intake prior to quarantine, very high. My activity, just trailing right behind it there, pretty active guy. As isolation has started, you can see that my activity has plummeted, while my caffeine intake has remained exactly the same.
Is the caffeine level red because that's a dangerously high level? Because that looks pretty intense.
I think that's a great reflection and an analysis of this graph. You know what? But I just kept whatever colors Excel gave me to begin with. And yes, I did plot these on Excel like a real professional. All right, let's go to the next graph. One is FaceTiming people.
This is one I think everyone can probably relate to.
Yes, before and after the quarantine. Before the quarantine, never FaceTimed a single soul because why would you?
Zero.
Completely unnecessary.
Why the fuck?
If I'm getting a FaceTime from you, I'm not going to answer that call, and you're probably going to be deleted from my contacts. After isolation, yeah. I love FaceTime. What's a better way to completely invade someone's privacy on a whim? You know, you just call them anytime during the day. They feel forced to answer because
anytime.
You know they're not doing anything else. I'm meeting people's girlfriends mm-hmm. for the first time, the kids, seeing the inside of their houses, checking them out in the toilet. It's great.
Very invasive.
Super invasive. It's really a way to invade on personal space without leaving mm-hmm. your home, and I'm really enjoying that feature of it. My last and
very
final
nice.
Graph, this one I've just been plotting, and
whoa,
I can find no
okay.
correlation in between before and after isolation. This is singing the chorus of random songs, both before and after quarantine, and as you can see, there's no real logic
to
this.
There's a lot of up and down here, but it seems like at the beginning and end, we're both hugging each other at the same point.
It's consistent. It's like for the last, 26 years, I've been singing the same random 10 to 12 songs that I only know the words to the chorus. These are things
right.
like Closing Time, Drops of Jupiter, I'm a Bitch, all the classics, I'm Like a Bird. And I'm proud to report and happy to report that these are remaining consistent throughout my isolation.
Wow, I don't know if that's good news or not, but congratulations.
Bryan, not only is it good news, it's great news, because without a nice song throughout your day, what's the point of living?
Alright, so up next we actually have our first video that we mentioned previously. So you want to go ahead and kick off this video that Tori Poole sent to
I'm
us?
I'm excited for it. Yes, our good friend Tori Poole sent us an update about how she's doing in isolation with her family.
Hi. I hope everybody's having a good pandemic.
Have you seen the toenail clippers?
It's pretty bleak. I'm at home. You want that in the video? Being at home is great. I mean,
food.
I'm getting to see a whole new side of parenting.
Hey, Ben!
I feel like the dogs are gonna suffer the most when and if the world goes back. Hi, baby.
Archer, get down. Wake up.
Go. And, you know, like, patience.
We're skating skateboard. Toenail clippers.
I'm learning how to be more resilient.
Go.
Yeah, I mean, my pandemic's fine. I mean, we're all healthy. My kid is waking up at 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock. Wake up, Bubba. Yeah, thanks for checking in. Miss you guys. I'm gonna fold my Native American blanket and pray to the gods that I don't know.
Great update from Tori. Seems like Jason's belly is doing well. What's up? Me? I was just thinking about kicking some ass later, so I gotta get my uniform. Ooh, God, you look good, baby.
We have a video from Gabby. What's this one about?
Gabby. Gabby submitted a very important video. During this quarantine time, it's quite easy to find yourself watching too much TV, too much of the necky flicks. So she has submitted some book recommendations.
Book recommendations. That's awesome. Yeah. Okay.
Let's take a look.
Well, hell yeah.
Oh my god, hey! Are you just like every other person that I know and lost a couple brain cells because you just finished watching The Tiger King? Well, I'm here today to recommend some quarantine reading. Right now, I'm currently hate reading The Silent Patient. A couple of friends recommended this to me, and guess what? We're no longer friends. This book sucks, but if you're white and you liked Gone Girl, give this a shot. She is white, keeps a diary, and kills her husband. These are not spoilers. It's the back of the fucking book. Something very, very relatable. A House in the Sky. Absolutely love this book. It's about a journalist, true story, who gets kidnapped in Somalia and who's held captive for 460 days. I kept waiting for her to kill herself, but she doesn't because she wrote this book. For all my friends who are parents and can't stop complaining about their children and sharing memes on social media that aren't funny, I highly recommend The Franklin Cover-Up. A true story about child abuse, Satanism, and murder in Nebraska. So next time you think about complaining about your child, why don't you think about these kids, you selfish fucks? They never saw their families ever again. For all my extrovert friends who are so ready to leave the house, I highly recommend this book, How to Change Your Mind, a book about psychedelics. Because if you can't physically leave the house, here's another way to leave the house. Take some LSD. For all you people who are worthless and don't know how to cook, I highly recommend Salt, Fat, Acid, Heat. Great book, awesome recipes. And you know what? If you don't want to read the fucking book, there's a special, same thing based on the book on Netflix. Just go watch that.
I will definitely be checking out at least one of those books.
Oh, you know what? I bet I will buy all of those books and probably read all of the first page.
Yeah, I have actually have a lot of books that I don't I buy books and then they just sit there, and I like the idea of owning books. Mm-hmm. It's just the idea of reading them is just goddamn, you know, I'd rather watch Netflix.
Yeah, it's like, but anyway, thanks, Gabby. I like to appear smart, but I actually don't want to be smart. Which is similar to why you buy books.
Book smart.
Next video coming
cool.
up.
Cool.
I'm excited about this one. We got Amador Salazar letting us know how his life's doing, how his cats are doing while in quarantine.
Man, this COVID shit's pretty serious. I'm nervous about it. How are you feeling, babe?
Enjoying extra time at home.
Yeah.
Time with the cats.
You're right.
God. Fucking boring. Quarantine's boring. Okay, I got it. Let's check out this. Tiger King, you heard of it? Everybody's talking about it. Let's watch that. All yeah? Right. Alright, let's do it.
Hey, all you cool cats and kittens!
No, how the fuck am I gonna make money off of you? I don't got a job. Chase it. Come on. Go. No? He ain't chasing. Here we go. We're gonna... No. Shush. Come on. We're gonna take a nice... Come on. Over here. Over here. This is supposed to be a nice little family photo, but you can't even... What the fuck is wrong with you?
Mama's got some treats for you.
Smile. Smile. Come on. You're supposed to smize. What the fuck? Come on. Oh, damn. Come on. We gotta get this photo. Come on. Libertarians rock.
All right. That was Amador Salazar again, showing us his life at home.
Amador Salazar, coming in hot with the cats. I'm glad to see that he is doing well.
Yeah, so our last and final video for you guys, for this special edition of Ecomody. I can't even say it. Why did we do this?
Ecomody? Is this Ecomody?
Comes from
David Sangiuliano.
You said it right.
I believe so. He submitted a very almost like a PSA, a good video, kind of a how-to of how to survive quarantine, keeping up with your teens, keeping up with your day-to-day
tips and tricks. Hell yeah, very excited for this one.
Check it out.
Hey, it's David here. I thought instead of trying to be silly, I'd be a little bit encouraging, let everybody know some of the things that I've been doing to sort of keep myself feeling like it's just a regular day. I'd set my alarm for a decent time to wake up in the morning, make sure to put some real clothes on, because come on, you know, you got to keep doing that. Brush your teeth. It really helps. You gotta remember your hygiene. Make yourself a nice breakfast. Have some coffee, just like you normally would. If you want to keep yourself busy, read a book.
What are you reading?
Mask of the Red Death.
Again?
Always.
I know a lot of us have instruments that we haven't been playing, and now's a good time. You have no excuse. Go ahead and practice that. Don't neglect your normal chores. They can pile up. Just go and tackle them. If you're locked in with your family, take some family time. Play a game.
And you're dead.
You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. Yeah.
That was easy. You're dead though.
And of course, you know, don't forget to shower. Again, hygiene is very important. Just try and keep it together. We're gonna make it through this.
That was David Sangiuliano showing us how to keep care of yourself, take care of yourself during quarantine. Thank you so much for all the comics for submitting your videos. Thank you guys for watching the virtual version of Ecomody Comedy. We'll probably do some more of these because as far as I can tell, we'll never go back outside ever again. It's been great being with you guys. I've been Christopher Breckell. That was Bryan Powell. You guys have an amazing night.